when I first moved here, there was that attraction to the city, like the freshness, the hustle, the excitement. But as that faded, I found how isolating it could be living in LA. Michelle and I went out and we were talking about what it's like to live in the city and make this city our home. And I explained to Michelle that I quickly realized as I started hiking that I found my groundings and I felt that I could grasp the city better. And there's something about getting above LA and looking down on it. And you realize that it's tangible, that this is a finite place that you can live in, you can conquer, if you will. And that's when I really felt at home in LA. When I could look upon it and see it as a city, as a place, rather than this never-ending sprawl of convenience stores and coffee shops.
Was different because we tripled the amount of submissions that we received, which was very exciting, but also obviously increased the amount of reading that we all needed to do. My name is Michelle Myring, and I'm the founder and editor of The Rattling Wall.
I'd never published a poem before. I published plenty of fiction and nonfiction essays and all that, and then I remembered, literally just, it was sort of like a little mini epiphany. I thought, oh my God, The Rattling Wall. So I went back and I had installed the first two issues and I thought, I'll send one of my poems. And so I went through and I sent, you know, three or four, and one of them got accepted and I was thrilled. I'm Panio Giannopoulos and I am a contributing writer to The Rattling Wall, issue 3. It's a weird analogy, but it's kind of like when you meet two people at the same time and you decide to start dating this person, right? But you just like, don't forget about that person, but obviously they're not in your life. But then you're sort of like, I wonder what happened to that person. I wonder what she's doing. Is she happy? Is she unhappy? So then it was a year later and I was like, oh, you know what? I'm not with this person anymore. I wonder what happened with her. So I went back and she was single and she liked my poems.
I'm always looking for venues where I can work. And I've been lucky to be able to work pretty widely. But for this kind of essay, you know, it's a little idiosyncratic, it's very interior. It's not the kind of thing that a more overtly commercial publication would probably have a place for. My eyes are always open for any venue that's kind of responsive to that kind of work. David L. Eulen, I'm a contributing writer to The Rattling Wall, issue 3.
I've had this passion for writing for years, you know, longer than I can remember. You know, you struggle at your craft, you put years into it, you practice, you study the masters, you put in your time, and then, you know, one day a mentor like Michelle tells you, you know, your work is ready for a broader audience. My name is Kate Reeves, and I am a contributing writer to The Rattling Wall, issue 3.
A lot happens before I can start piecing the book together, and so I pretty much start when I receive the rough draft of the whole book. And then while I'm reviewing that and working with the artist to put together the illustrations, the editorial department is refining the draft, doing all of the copy editing, and getting it to a close to finished form. My name's Mark Dischler, and I'm the art director at Narrow Books.
When we were coming up with the idea for the design, we wanted to do something really unique, and we'd noticed that there were other journals and collections that featured artwork of various artists, but we wanted to feature the artwork of a single artist so that there could be a unifying quality to each issue. And in the case of the Rattling Wall issue 3, it gave Ben the opportunity to create a whole new set of artwork that specifically was paired with this journal.
Well, the things that really inspire me are kind of like funny or banal kind of moments, you know. My name is Ben Teagle, and I'm the featured artist in the Rattling Wall issue 3. I think it's very hard for artists or illustrators to, and maybe for writers too, to really understand how what they're doing is going to be received. I mean, I kind of feel like the way I think about the drawings or that I make, like, isn't necessarily how other people see them. You know, they see all their stuff differently, the way the audience, like, I like watch this thing about like Woody Allen, where like, you know, Woody Allen thinks that like Manhattan is like a terrible movie, and everybody else thinks it's like his best movie, and he looks at it and he's like, this was a piece of crap, like, I hate this movie, he doesn't like it. He just sees it differently.
Do you have any kids or anything like
me? Yeah, I got a kid. He's really? Being raised by two women at the moment.
You know, I mean, I think that works. They made some studies. I read in one of the psychoanalytic quarterlies. You don't need a male. I mean, two mothers are absolutely fine.
Really? Because I always feel very few people survive one mother.
I come up with some ideas or like little tiny thumbnail sketches or something, and then like I'd get together with Mark. He'd come over to my place, and we'd just like talk about it.
Ben definitely brought his own variety of humor to some of the illustrations. I think that people who are fans of his work will definitely recognize these as Ben Teagle pieces, and people who aren't familiar with his work will definitely get to see a pretty broad range of different styles.
This time I would say that the issue of home was most striking to me. So we had home in a place, home in a person, home in a set of routines. It really is from start to finish an exploration of what home is and where we can find it and how we can hope to find it.
I think when we are home, we may not realize how important home is. It's when we travel or we're away from home, then we become homesick. My name is Joyce Carol Oates. I'm a contributor to issue 3 of The Rattling Wall. It's almost as if you have to leave home to realize the value of a home.
And when I moved over here and I would be driving on the freeway, like the 110, there's that one part where you go through and it's just the buildings just kind of spring up on the side of you like a diorama. And just driving through that, something about the anonymity, it's just really welcoming, and that feels like home to me. Maritza K. Rubio, I'm a contributing writer to issue 3 of The Rattling Wall.
Casey Curry and I were having lunch, and after this lunch, we started talking about when we felt at home in Los Angeles. And Casey very clearly stated that he first felt at home in Los Angeles as soon as he started hiking here. And I started to wonder when it was I felt at home inside of Los Angeles. So the Rattling Wall had been invited to participate in this second annual lit ball softball championship showdown. I drove from Santa Monica, I bought a softball mitt and a case of Coors Light, and I drove to the softball park. The Rattling Wall formed this sort of misfit softball team. So I was standing out in the field, and I had been thinking about this question for a long time, and I look back at the bleachers where Ava made this wonderful colored marker sign that says "Go Rattling Wall" on it, and people are cheering for the Rattling Wall, and I'm standing out there with my brand new mitts, and it really became evident to me for the first time how people rely on this thing and they feel comfortable with this thing, and they are eager to join us. At that point, I realized that I felt at home inside of Los Angeles at the point where I had created something here.